Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today I'm excited to give you guys my first impressions on one of the most anticipated games of the year, at least to me. The game I'm talking about is Proteus. It's a retro FPS in design, but in style and presentation, it is very much a modern shooter. If you've been a little hesitant to get into some of the retro indie shooters that have been popping up recently, well, Proteus might be your gateway game because the mechanics are very modern. It's a fast-paced, blood-soaked spiritual successor to the original Doom games with a fantastic sci-fi aesthetic. Believe it or not, there are certainly people out there that prefer the original Doom to, say, the new modern Doom Eternal. They think the glory kills, resource management system, and enemies like the Marauder that can block damage somewhat go against the pedal to the metal nonstop action of the original games. And while I'm certainly somebody that appreciates the Doom remakes and thinks they're phenomenal in so many ways, I also understand the sentiment of enjoying the specific style that the original Doom games brought to the FPS world. But if maybe you never played the original Doom games or you really miss that feeling, Proteus is absolutely going to give you that feeling, but in a much more modernized package. In a lot of ways, Proteus feels like what Doom 3 might have been if it hadn't taken the horror FPS route. It has that same always moving and fast weapon swappy gameplay from the first two Doom games, but updates everything with a fresh coat of paint. It also doesn't suffer from the weird technical limitations of some other modern retro shooters. Ion Fury, for example, uses the build engine. And while that is an incredible feat, as no modern commercial game has really used the build engine for like 25 years, it really does limit what the developers could do in terms of level design, AI quality, and a lot more. While other retro shooters like Dusk and A Medieval use modern technology to great effect, many don't particularly enjoy their aesthetics. And I do get that to a certain extent. It's hard to strike a balance between old school aesthetics and new school games, but I think that's exactly what Proteus does perfectly. And what's really cool is that the game even allows you to enable 3D models for enemies to replace their sprites. Personally, I think the sprites look better and sell the game's look and feel a bit better, but if you in fact prefer 3D models, it is an option. And speaking of options, there's actually a surprising amount available to change the game's visuals. You can lower the rendering resolution, adjust the dithering, apply a CRT filter, and more. You can make Proteus look incredibly retro or go for a fully modern, no heads-up display experience. I settled on playing with the HUD off, sprites enabled, and visual filters turned off, and I think the end result really speaks for itself. The game is just dripping with eye candy. Now, the footage you've been watching is from the game's current playtest build. It offers a prologue level, one full level, and a challenge mission. It's pretty limited in terms of how much content you can explore, but that hasn't stopped me from replaying it multiple times. Every run-through got me a little bit closer to a truly optimized path. That said, the campaign is supposed to be just one small part of the Proteus package. It also has a fully featured level editor and lets you create and share levels with other players in game. So, if you want to see what Doom E1 M1 would look like in Proteus, you can just boot up someone's E1 M1 custom level and go to town. Proteus will also support custom campaigns, though I haven't seen any available in game as of writing this. Now, as for multiplayer, the devs are planning to include that in the game's 1.0 release along with co-op. It's entering early access on November 10th, so the 1.0 launch is probably a bit of a ways off. If the playtest build is anything to go by for the final product, though, I am 100% sold. Visuals and aesthetics aside, the gameplay in Proteus is actually really what sells the experience. All of the guns, even the basic starting pistol, have weight and punch to them that makes them feel powerful. And the way enemies burst into bloody, mangled messes sells the impact of every shot. Once the game starts throwing lots of enemies at you, things really start to speed up. You can sprint and strafe to dodge enemy attacks, even in tight corridors and interior rooms of some areas, it still feels like there's ample room to maneuver. Really, as soon as the game gave me a gun and put enemies on the screen, I felt right at home. The muscle memory that you've all built up playing classic FPS games applies perfectly to Proteus. I posted a clip of the game on Twitter and someone replied saying it looks like what they remember Doom being like as a kid. Obviously, Doom doesn't look nearly as impressive today as it does in our memories, but that evolved mental image is exactly what Proteus, I think, is striving to be. Some people might say that makes the game feel too familiar, but I think that kind of is the point. In a way, Proteus feels like the perfectly crafted nostalgic tribute. Because if you went back to play Doom or Doom 2 without having played them since you first played them when they released, well, you might be a little bit underwhelmed by the clunky nature of the game or really just how dated the visuals truly are. But if you load up Proteus, it's going to make you feel like you're playing the original Doom, but you're going to be satisfied with the modern gameplay mechanics and very much updated visuals that still employ that retro pixelated look. Now, all that said, and as much as I love Proteus and am absolutely going to play the full thing once it launches, there are a few negatives. While the guns and music sound incredible, enemy death and attack audio seems kind of bland and doesn't sell the blood pinata visuals that well. These zombie demon bastards are getting ripped apart by shotguns and dual assault rifles, so you'd expect something more than a demonic grumbling noise as they're eviscerated. Likewise, the environmental soundscapes and some of the other sound effects are a little subdued. A little more ambiance and punch to stuff like opening doors and exploding barrels could go a long way. The game uses a shared ammo system, which means multiple guns will use the same type of ammo. I found this to be really restrictive, and I relied on one or two weapons in every playthrough instead of using all of the available weapons as needed. Despite Proteus offering a ton of old school visual options, it doesn't offer many old school gameplay options. A no reload option or even the ability to center weapon view models would give it an even more retro feel without totally changing how it plays. Obviously, those aren't big issues, but I could see it being a requested feature for somebody who really wants to emulate certain old school feelings. Now, one issue that I can't say I've exactly experienced in any other game before is that all the blood and gibs filling the screen actually made it hard to see at times. And I know that's kind of a funny complaint, but the sheer amount of gore in Proteus sometimes gets in the way of just actually playing the game. An option to maybe tone down the blood fountains by a small factor might be nice if you are actually working on speed runs or just maximizing your efficiency. Now, my last complaint is very much a nitpick, but performance on max settings was a little bit disappointing. Bumping the game up to max settings dropped my frame rate from like 200 plus FPS down to like 70. Turning off screen space ambient occlusion and reflections will dramatically improve your FPS, and I wouldn't say the difference is night and day visually, so it's at least worth it to disable one so that you can get that high FPS action. And again, many of these complaints are extremely minor and I think are not going to take away from the overall experience in any sort of major way. Overall, I think Proteus is a massive win for the retro FPS genre, and I think it's actually going to bring a lot of people in who might have not gone for the other retro FPS games out there. Brutal Doom is probably the closest game I can think of to compare it to, but unlike Brutal Doom, Proteus doesn't revel in excess. The available campaign mission isn't overly long, and it doesn't throw a sea of enemies at you constantly. It's clearly designed by people that understand good pacing and level design, so I'm very excited to see what the rest of the campaign is like. And even if for some reason the rest of the campaign doesn't meet my expectations, well, there's always the level editor and custom campaign system that I'm sure could offer endless content. Like half the campaign for Doom 2016 is already available in Proteus as custom levels, so just imagine what it's going to be like when the game is widely available. Now, if you want to get your hands on Proteus before its early access launch November 10th, you can sign up for playtesting on the game's Steam page. While it's only available on PC right now, the developers are releasing Proteus on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and Nintendo Switch when it reaches its 1.0 build. I'll leave a link to the game's Steam page in the video description if you'd like to check it out, and I'd really be curious to hear what you guys think. What do you think of the retro FPS craze? Does Proteus appeal to you a lot more than some of the other retro FPS games that have been making headlines? Let me know in the comments. Be sure to subscribe to catch more first impressions videos like this one. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.